questions based on impulse momentum theorem. Let us solve few very basic questions. First question. There are two identical balls. Ball 1 has mass 0.5 kg. This is moving with 10 meter per second. Another ball B, having same mass, was moving with say 5 meter per second or say 10 meter per second. Both the balls collide and start moving with same speed, but in opposite direction. After the collision, calculate impulse imparted to ball A and ball B. What is the value of impulse imparted to ball A and ball B? Now, so the case is like this: ball was moving with 5 meter per second towards right. This was before collision. After collision, it started moving with, this is before collision, before, and this is after. After collision, it started moving with 5 meter per second towards left. Initial momentum of the ball is, momentum is a vector quantity, mass multiplied by velocity, 0.5, it is 10, velocity is 10, mass was 0.5, my mistake. So before it was moving with 10 meter per second, mass 0.5 kg, initial momentum is mass into velocity I cap, it is moving towards right. Final momentum of ball is 0.5 multiplied by minus 10 I cap. So change in momentum, which is actually impulse, is final momentum minus initial momentum minus 5 I cap minus 5 I cap, which is minus 10 I cap, which is minus 10 I cap. It is minus 10 I cap. Similarly, for ball B, initially it was moving with 10 meter per second towards left before and after. After the collision, it was moving towards right with again 10 meter per second. So impulse imparted to ball A was minus 10 I cap, magnitude is 10, right? I'm going to erase it now because I'm solving it for ball B now. Initial momentum is 0.5 into 10 minus I cap, moving towards left. Final momentum is mass into velocity I cap. Change in momentum of ball B, which is actually impulse imparted to ball B, is final momentum minus initial momentum, 5 I cap minus of minus 5 I cap, which is actually 10 I cap, or impulse imparted to ball A was minus 10 I cap, impulse imparted to ball B was 10 I cap. Extremely easy question. I just calculated the change in momentum individually for both the balls, right? Kindly note down. Let us take another example. Ball was dropped from height of 20 meters. It strikes the ground floor. It remains in contact with the floor for 0.01 seconds. It remains in contact with the floor for 0.01 second. And then rebounds to a height of 10 meters. Calculate impulse imparted to the ball force exerted by ground. I'm not writing that ball is dropped, it is self-explanatory. Let us take initial velocity to be zero. So it is dropped from height of 20 meters, strikes the ground, rebounds to a height of 10 meters, right? You have to calculate impulse imparted to the ball, force exerted by ground. Let us take mass of ball to be 0.1 kg. Now I will take this direction j cap, this direction minus j cap, right? When a ball is dropped from height h, it acquires a velocity v on reaching the ground. So now I will we will study the motion from A to B, then we will study from B to C. A to B, v square minus u square equals to 2as. Initial velocity is 0, acceleration minus g, displacement is minus h1, v is under root 2gh1, 2 times g is 10, height is also 20. Oh, we got 20 meter per second. Square root was easy to calculate. So ball strikes the ground with a velocity of 20 minus j cap. Now I have added a direction to it. 20 was just the magnitude. 20 times minus j cap, right? On striking the ground, it rebounds with some other velocity, say v2. Now we are going to study motion from B to C. Okay, v square minus u square equal to 2as. Final velocity is 0 at the highest point. At C point, body will be momentarily at rest. Initial velocity is, say, v2 square. Acceleration is minus g. Displacement is h2. We get v2 to be under root 2gh2. V2 is under root 2 into 10 into 10. Right? It is 10. 10 root 2. V2 is 10 into 1.414, V2 is 14.14 meter per second. It is an upward direction, so velocity will be, final velocity will be 14.14 j cap. Final velocity is in upward direction, it is 14.14 j cap. Okay. Now impulse is actually change in linear momentum, and I'll divide that change in linear momentum by time, I'll get the value of force. So impulse, let us calculate impulse now. Impulse is equal to change in linear momentum. Final momentum is, mass is 0.1 kg. Velocity is 14.14 j cap. Initial momentum is 0.1, 20 minus 20 j cap. It is 1.414 j cap plus 2 times j cap, 3.414 j cap is the value of impulse imparted to the body. Magnitude of this impulse is 3.414 newton second. This is also newton second. Now if I want to calculate the force also, impulse is force multiplied by time, 3.414. It is 3.414. F multiplied by time, what is the time? Time was 0.01 second. Force is 3.414 divided by 0.01 Newton. This is 341.4 Newton. Quite a large force. Impulse was force into time. Value of force is quite large. It was dropped from 20 meter, strikes the ground, rebounds to a height of 10 meter. We were asked to calculate impulse and the force, and we calculated it very easily. Okay. Kindly note down. Let us take another easy example. There is a ball. Ball was moving with velocity u. It strikes the wall, then rebounds with same speed. Calculate impulse imparted to the ball. Ball strikes the wall and it rebounds with same speed. Calculate impulse imparted. Now, taking the right direction to be positive, left direction to be negative, upward to be positive, downward to be negative, or this to be I cap and this to be J cap. Initial momentum of the ball is mu I cap. Final momentum of the ball is minus mu I cap. Impulse is actually nothing but change in linear momentum. J is P final minus P initial. Minus mu I cap, minus mu I cap. J is minus 2 times mu I cap. Magnitude of J is 2 times mu. This is impulse imparted to the ball. Now I will take another example. Likewise, ball will come at an angle, it will rebound, it will get reflected at the same angle. In that case, we have to resolve the value of linear momentum, and then we will calculate change in linear momentum like in the previous question. Okay. Now we have question number 4 here. Question number 4. There is a wall. A ball strikes the wall at some angle. Mass of the ball is m. Velocity is u. Strikes an at angle theta. Rebounds moves with velocity u at the same angle. You have to calculate impulse. Calculate J. Let us make things simple. Calculate impulse imparted to the ball. I am going to resolve the value of linear momentum here. This is theta, this is theta alternate angle. This is mu cos theta and this is mu sin theta. Let us make coordinate axis plus minus plus minus. Initial momentum is mu cos theta I cap plus mu sin theta minus j cap, since it is directed towards minus j direction, negative y axis direction. Okay, resolve this momentum also. This is theta, so this will be theta, corresponding angle mu cos theta, mu sin theta. Let us write the momentum, final momentum, in vector form. Mu cos theta, mu cos theta towards left, towards left means minus I cap, mu sin theta downwards, downwards means minus j cap. Impulse, sure shot impulse means final momentum minus initial momentum. So these two things get cancelled out. We get minus 2 mu cos theta I cap. Magnitude of impulse here is 2 mu cos theta. Okay, we have discussed two cases precisely: ball striking perpendicular to the wall, rebounding with same speed. Impulse was 2 mu, magnitude of impulse was 2 mu. Ball striking the wall at some angle theta. Magnitude of impulse was 2 times mu cos theta. So the ratio J2 divided by J1 is cos theta. This may be also a good objective question. Impulse imparted in one case is J2, impulse imparted in other case is J1. What is the ratio of J2 and J1? It is certainly cos theta. Theta is the angle made by the direction of motion of the ball with the horizontal, right? So it was an easy question. It is an NCERT question. Kindly note down the solution. I hope you are going to you are able to understand . Now I am going to calculate impulse from XT graph. Important, XT graph, displacement time graph or position time graph. Suppose we have an XT graph here. XT graph is like this. This is for t less than 0. This is for t 0 to 4 seconds. This is again greater than 4 seconds. You have to calculate mass of the body is say 1 kg, whose XT graph is as shown. A body has mass 1 kg whose XT graph is as shown. You have to calculate impulse at first part is t equal to 0 seconds. Second part is, let this x be, okay, 10 meters and t is equal to 4 seconds. XT graph, the displacement or the position does not change with time. Before t less than 0, body was at rest. A force acted on the body for 4 seconds. Or you can say that, we cannot say that a force acted on the body for 4 seconds. Like, this is displacement versus time graph. Velocity is constant, but acceleration is 0 here. So a force is not acting on the body. We just gave a sudden impulse, a sudden push to the body at t equal to 0. So at t less than 0, body was at rest, initial velocity is 0. At t, or you can say t tends to 0 minus, just less than 0, t approaches to 0 plus 0.00001 seconds, body was moving with velocity. Slope of XT graph gives velocity 10 by 4, perpendicular by base tan theta, body is moving with 2.5 meter per second, this is velocity. Impulse is again change in linear momentum. mass of the body is, okay, 1 kg, 2.5 minus 0, this is 2.5 newton second. At t equal to 0 seconds, an impulse of 2.5 newton second acted on the body. Let us solve it for t equals to 4. I am going to erase the question. At t equals to 4 seconds, t approaches to 0 minus, velocity of the body is 4 meter per second. U is, it is 10 by 4. It is 2.5 meter per second. T approaches to 0 plus, again body was at rest, V is 0. Impulse is change in momentum. J equals to m into V minus U. Mass of the body is 1 kg. V is 0. U is 2.5. Impulse imparted to this ball is minus 2.5 newton second. So an impulse of 2.5 newton second acts at t equal to 0 seconds. And an impulse of minus 2.5 newton seconds acts on the body at exactly t equal to 4 seconds.